On March 27, 3 days after election, the Pheu Thai Party led several political parties announcing to form a coalition government, claiming of having more than half of 500 seats in the House of Representatives. ธนาธรจึงรุ่งเรืองกิจ the billionaire turned politician, leader of the Future Forward Party, which holds more than 80 MPs, joined this camp. He believes this is the right path of pursuing a new democratic government.
The task of forming the coalition government is with Pheu Thai. Pheu Thai is the party that wins the most seat in the election, so we have to respect democratic tradition. I don't know how deep Pheu Thai has discussed the forming of the coalition with Phum Chai Thai. I have no idea about that. We are still waiting for Pheu Thai signal if and when they could form a coalition government. So we remain passive in the forming of the government to this day.
Any chance do you think that Pheu Thai may propose you as Prime Minister candidate from the camp led by Pheu Thai?
I don't know. I have no idea what it's going to take to stop the continuation of the NCPO regime. But like we said earlier, the priority, the first task, the first mission of Future Forward Party after the election is to stop the NCPO power, is to stop the stay in the power of the regime. So we are ready to do whatever it takes to stop them from staying in power. We believe if we could form a democratic government, it will open new possibilities to bring the country back to a democratic path.
Last Saturday, on April the 6th, Thanachorn appeared at the Pathum Wan police station to hear charges against him. His appearance was under international spotlight when foreign diplomats from many countries attended at the legal prosecution. Members of the Future Forward Party, Thanachorn and Piyabut Sangkanopkun, Secretary General, are facing 12 legal charges altogether. The success and obstacles of the party appear almost at the same time.
After election, have you talked among party members and whether the victory of coming at the third political party, is it coming too fast, too soon for Future Forward Party?
I would say it is expected among the party executives. We know that this is the range we are looking for before the election happened. We know that it will be somewhere here, somewhere between 75 to 100. We did a lot of internal surveys. I walked the market since almost a year ago when nobody recognized me until few weeks before the election where the whole market did know my face. So I recognized the increasing popularity of the party and we could gauge the number of seats we could win in the election, and it's not very far off our projection. It's within the range of our projection. So it did not surprise us. It may surprise many political experts in academics or in the media organizations, but for us, it is the result didn't surprise us. However, having said that, the challenges by means of the legal charges that was put upon us, that though we are ready, though we expected them, we thought these charges are coming too soon. We didn't expect them to come this many, this fast. Altogether, the party and its leadership has accumulated some 12 cases already over the past 1 year. 12 cases.
Election might have finished, But the real legal battles may have just begun for Thanathorn. He stands firm that the only weapon he has is 6.2 million voters who support the Future Forward Party. Natha Gomonwatin, Thai PBS World Reports.